guys, I hope you're doing well. I wanted to let you guys know that today I'm going in for my rheumatology appointment. I have little Miss Olivia with me in the back seat. And we came here earlier, but the doctor wasn't ready for us. So we had to go take a lunch break and now we're back.
What symptoms did you have when they diagnosed you?
I was actually having chest pain, and I thought it was my heart, and I was super tired, and just from doing nothing. So I would just be sitting there and constantly out of breath and couldn't breathe. So I thought it was my heart, so I made an appointment and saw a cardiologist, and he said my heart was perfectly fine, but then he accidentally tested me for the ANA and the titter. And then that came back positive and everything, and he referred me to the rheumatologist.
Do you remember if you had any other antibodies other than the positive ANA when the rheumatologist did you blood work?
Not that I remember.
Did you have any joint pain at that point?
No, I don't normally get like joint pain at all. Thankfully.
So what did the rheumatologist do?
She went ahead and she saw my rash I normally get on my back. I think I have it. I might have it now.
Okay.
And so I had a rash on my back and a few other places, and then some of my just other symptoms. And she kind of looked at my family history and everything. And so.
She put you on medications.
Yeah, she put me on the hydroxychloroquine. Uh-huh. 200 milligrams, and it was just once per day.
Okay.
And then I took that ever since until maybe just 2 months ago. And that's because my insurance in California ran out, and so I got the Oklahoma Sunicare, and the new doctor here prescribed me, it's supposed to be Plaquenil still, it's just a different brand. But I took that for about a week, and I just didn't feel well on it.
Okay.
And so I don't know if I need a different brand or what.
Okay. And did your symptoms get better on Plaquenil?
Yeah, after a while, and then I think towards the end of it, it seemed like it wasn't doing as much as it did before. But definitely a difference, because I can even tell just being off of it now. Got your cheese? It's kind of changed. I had it when I was younger, and it started off, I don't know, maybe around 7, 8, and I even had it, they started off as like white spots everywhere, and as I got older, they kind of turned red, and then even sometimes like a brownish color, and then almost like scaly a little bit. But I never noticed it too much just because it was always on my back.
So what issues are you having right now?
I'd say burning. I always get burning. I don't know if it's around my lungs or right here.
Like inside or the skin?
Inside, yeah. It's more of the trouble breathing and stuff again. This is my normal spot. Like it burns really bad here. Where I get sharp pains where my heart is. And then I get sores on my head. Different sores on my head. Tons of fatigue, lightheaded. Those are my normal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Fevers?
Yeah.
How high do they go?
Probably just like 100. Yeah, around 100.
Ulcers in your mouth or nose could come and go frequently.
I've had ulcers in my mouth.
Okay. How often do you get those?
Whenever I just really have a flare up, I definitely get them.
Breaking out when exposed to sunlight.
It's kind of weird because I've been the opposite. It's whenever I'm in cold air. That's when I feel the worst. But I definitely put on tons of sunscreen and stuff when I go out in the sun.
Fingers, toes turn white. It's very painful when it's supposed to
be cold temperatures. They're not painful so much. I mean, there is pain, but they turn purple, kind of purplish.
Any joints getting big, red, hot, swollen? Mm-mm. Any very painful joints?
Mm-mm.
Severe dryness in your eyes or mouth?
Mm-mm.
Any unexpected weight loss?
No. I kind of fluctuate.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I do get like stomach ulcers and stuff whenever I have like a flare.
Have you ever had any issues with blood loss? Have to take blood tests?
No.
What about miscarriages?
Yeah, I had a really bad miscarriage in 2015, right before her. And I ended up having a DNC and then ended up in the ICU with blood transfusions and stuff.
How far along were you?
I was about 11 weeks.
Any history of seizures?
No.
Anybody in your family with history of lupus?
My mom has MS. My grandma has a very rare, she just passed away from it, a very rare autoimmune disease that attacks the liver. I don't know what it's called though.
Primary biliary cirrhosis?
I have no idea.
So, did I hear you're pregnant?
Yes, and I'm 10 weeks.
10 weeks. Who is your gynecologist?
Katie Jones in UConn.
Did you take black vanilla?
I did.
Through
yeah.
Her pregnancy. Okay. mind if I check, Mom?
Lots of blood, and then I'll need to get a urine.
Yeah.
Tell me your birthday.
Too. It was nice. I remember when my daughter's 10 now though.
Mhm.
So her grandparents first got them like at the something up here in the city. We weren't from here. On the base.
The Nuka. She gets the same like sippy cups and everything. Mm-hmm. Olivia, you know you're making a mess.
Okay, are we ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go.
Watch, baby.
Yeah!
Not a toy, definitely not a toy. No.
She's like, it's all colorful.
Olivia, come here. Is that silly?
Hello.
You'll be good.
She is just not happy back there, huh?
She wants to play with all these.
She's like, why can't I play with them?
I'm blocking her in. Ooh.
Bracelet? Around your arm?
Take it.
He's like, no. I want the other stuff.
Yeah.
No? Okay. No, I always had so much. My daughter, love her to death. She knew strangers were bad. Never talked to strangers.
She's,
she never met a stranger, but she knew. That you don't talk to strangers.
She's the same way. She's even like that with like her grandma.
Oh yeah.
Stuff. So it's kind of funny.
Okay, Rachel, yeah. You
see?
Oh, isn't that funny?
Anywhere we went out in public, she just walk up and talk to anybody. I'm like, stop talking to people.